Thank you, Mr. President. Fake news is, of course, of all ages. It has always been there. It comes from many states and also from private actors. But today, in the internet age, it is for people very unclear where does it come from? Who has sent this news? And in order, indeed, like the Commission has said, to have media literacy, it should be clear who has written these messages. Interesting is that those who were at Maidan Square to be there to support the democratic revolution against, let me say, the cronies of Mr. Putin, we find ourselves back on internet. I've seen myself at Maidan Square with big guns in my hands. But the guns were that big that they were bigger than my hands itself. So normally you should say it's nonsense. But people believe it. Why were you at Maidan Square with a gun? Well, again, I was not. So I am sympathetic to the idea of Macron, President Macron of France, to say it must be transparent, also on platforms, where does the news come from? It's not to have, let me say, a negative impact on news. There should be freedom of news, but it should be transparent. Where does it come from? You have also to see who sponsors it. Because if you read on the internet, you should know, is this supported by a state or by a private agency? So there must be transparency. That is the most important thing concerning this. And again, the best thing is that we provide not counter-propaganda, but facts. Facts, 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 so that the Russians, but also the Chinese people and others can have access to sources they normally don't have. Again, let us try to be active and not selective. So it's not only Russia. Yeah, it's Russia, but it's also China and others. Thank you very much.